Hello and welcome to my talk on table motion detection in interventional coronary angiography. First, I would like to give some medical background about the problem. ICA, which is considered the gold standard for diagnosis of a coronary artery disease, lacks the depth information, and that's why it suffers from projection artifacts such as vessel overlap and foreshortening. Vessel overlap can happen due to the vessel crossing in angiograms, whereas the vessel foreshortening can happen whenever the vessel of interest is not parallel to the detector. These limitations of ICA can be overcome by creating a 3D model of the arterial tree. This will allow us to utilize 3D coronary analysis to evaluate the performance of a segmented lumen. To create a 3D model, we at least require two projection images from two different view angles that are required at least 30 degrees apart for the same cardiac phase. So once we have acquired two projection images from two different view angles, then we have to manually select few points on an angiogram, then corresponding points on another angiogram would be fine using a triangulation. This requires a prior information about the acquisition geometry, such as the distance between source and image and the pixel spacing of the detector. In a typical ICA acquisition, the patient table is translated to follow the contrast agent. This shift in table actually disturbs the initially calibrated geometry, and hence the frames which are captured only before the table motion will be available for further processing and to create a 3D model of the arterial tree. Here is an example of an ICA acquisition. In this example, frames from 1 to 55 does not show any table motion as spine is static throughout these frames, whereas frames from 56 to 82 shows a shift in spine from right to left as these frames are captured during table motion, and hence these frames and the frames after them cannot be utilized for the 3D modeling of the arterial tree. So the goal of the study was to find the frames which are captured before table motion using a special temporal model of deep learning. So once we have identified these frames, then we can utilize them to create a 3D model of the arterial tree. To train a spatiotemporal model, we have acquired 158 angiographic scenes from 28 different patients at 15 frames per second from 3 different clinical sites. These frames were manually annotated between moving frames, the frames which were captured during table motion, and static frames, the frames which are captured before and after table motion. Because the angiographic scenes were of varying lengths, that's why we have divided them into temporal blocks of 32 frames. We have chosen the block size 32 so that network can learn to distinguish between different types of movement in an angiographic scene. So once we have divided the angio scenes into the temporal blocks, then we have resized the frames of the temporal blocks to the standard size. After that, we have improved the contrast, and in the last step, we have applied the minimum pooling to make the background of the frames of these temporal blocks a little bit more prominent. Spatiotemporal neural networks can detect and distinguish movement in a 3D scene. We have defined three different spatiotemporal networks to classify static and moving frames in an angiographic sequence. Network 1 was consisted of only 3D CNN spatiotemporal layer. Convallostrium network only consisted of a convallostrium spatiotemporal layer. Fusion network consisted of both 3D CNN and convallostrium spatiotemporal layers. The reason for choosing the different depth for all three architecture was that 3D CNN has difficulty to model the long-term temporal dependencies among the frames of an angiographic sequence. Convallostrium can model these long-term temporal dependencies, but it requires much more parameters compared to the 3D CNN network. Fusion network can also model long-term temporal dependencies, and it requires much less parameter compared to the convallostrium network. So once we have extracted the features for all three networks, then time distributed dense layer with softmax function was used to make predictions on the frames of each temporal block of the angiographic sequence. All three networks were trained with the binary cross entropy loss and the Adam optimizer. The class imbalance was significant as all the angio sequences contain much more static frames compared to the moving frames which are captured during table motion. To tackle this problem, we have added multiple copies of temporal blocks that consisted of only moving frames into the respective training and validation sets, so that our training dataset will become balanced for both classes, static and moving. The table here depicts the performance of all three networks. The 3DCNN CONVAL-STM network outperformed the other two networks and achieved the macroeffectiveness score of 93%. The 3DCNN network was only able to achieve the macroeffectiveness score of 80%. The performance of CONVAL-STM network lies in between 3DCNN and 3DCNN CONVAL-STM network, and it was able to achieve the macroeffectiveness score of 86%. The results for clinical site 2 and the angiographic sequences showing right coronary artery shows that the trained model for the 3DCNN CONVAL-STM network has generalized well, as they were severely underrepresented in the training data. But still, the trained model for the 3DCNN CONVAL-STM network was able to achieve the similar F1 score for them as it achieves a macro F1 score on the complete test set. As mentioned earlier, increasing the depth of the CONVAL-STM and the 3DCNN architecture leads to the overfitting and further degrades their performance. The figure on the right shows the temporal movement in an angiographic scene along a vertical line. Then we have selected as an example the temporal movement of one vertebra and overlaid this on the classification result. This superimposition shows that the 3DCNN CONVAL-STM network can successfully distinguish between the moving and the static frames of an angiographic sequence. The misclassifications that were mainly happened were due to the difference between the leading edge of the ground truth and the prediction and the trailing edge of the ground truth and the prediction. To further evaluate the performance of the trained model, we have plotted the box plots showing the absolute difference between the leading edge of ground truth and prediction and the trailing edge of ground truth and prediction. It shows that the maximum absolute difference for both the leading edge and the trailing edge was of 5 frames. The mean absolute error was of 1.37 frames for the leading edge, and it was 1.61 frames for the trailing edge. The experiment and results shows that the 3DCNN CONVAL-STM network successfully distinguishes table motion in the angiographic scene from heart and respiratory movements, as it encodes longer temporal information with much less complexity. The CONVAL-STM network also works reasonably well, but it classified static frames as moving when there is a sudden change in the successive frame, usually at the beginning of the contrast flow. The 3DCNN network only worked well when there was no significant diaphragm motion and the effects of heart movement and heart shadow were minimal. In conclusion, the result shows that the trained model for the 3DCNN CONVAL-STM network can robustly classify table motion frames since all three clinical sites and RC and LCA scenes yield similar F1 scores. The temporal error of the leading and trailing edge was less than 2 frames on average, and actually this can easily be taken into account in a simple post-processing step while choosing the suitable calibrated frames for the 3D modeling of the arterial tree. This study is currently limited to acquisition with a frame rate of 15 FPS, but extension to variable frame rates are planned for future work. Furthermore, we aim to incorporate the information of the table motion predictor from this study to another network that estimates the real table motion directly. Thank you for your attention. I'm open to questions.